Inspect all parts for excessive wear or for any nicks or burrs. Remove nicks or burrs using emery cloth or a fine file. Replace any parts that are badly worn or damaged. It is recommended that gaskets and O-rings be replaced whenever your pump is reassembled. When reinstalling pump components after disassembly, refer to the table in the manual accompanying your pump for hardware torque specifications. It is recommended that the bearing be replaced during maintenance. However, if the bearing must be reused, rotate the bearing by hand to check for roughness or binding. If rotation is rough, or there is any side-to-side movement between the inner and outer races, the bearing must be replaced. The bearing is permanently sealed and requires no additional lubrication except a coating of light oil on external surfaces to ease reassembly. External surfaces must be kept free of all dirt and foreign material. Failure to do so could damage the bearing or its mating surfaces. Coat the bearing with light oil. The bearing tolerance provides a light press fit into the rotor adjusting sleeve. Replace the rotor adjusting sleeve if the proper fit is not achieved. When replacing bushings, lightly oil the OD of the replacement bushing before installation. If your pump is equipped with carbon graphite bushings, be very careful when installing the bushings. Graphite is extremely brittle and will crack if improperly installed. Use a press to install the bushing with one continuous motion until the bushing is fully seated. Stopping in mid-stroke will cause the bushing to crack. After installation, check the bushing for cracks. When installing high-temperature graphite bushings, heat the part that receives the bushing to 500 degrees Fahrenheit. This will allow easier installation with less chance of breakage. Position the backhead on the bed of a press with the rotor end facing up. Use a suitably sized dowel to press the assembled shaft bushing sleeve and shaft bushing into the backhead until fully seated. Install a new gasket over the shaft bushing sleeve. Position the balance hole as shown and secure the backhead assembly to the housing with the cap screws. Secure the foot bracket to the backhead with the previously removed hardware. Inspect the rotor and shaft assembly for excessive wear, scoring, or scratches along the shaft sealing surface. If replacement is required, the shaft and rotor must be replaced as an assembly. Small scratches can be dressed with a fine file or emery cloth. Replace the rotor and shaft assembly or any other parts if wear or damage is extensive. Slide the rotor shaft assembly into the housing and backhead. Use caution not to scratch or chip the ID of the shaft bushing. Clean the seal cavity and shaft with a cloth soaked in fresh cleaning solvent. It is recommended that replacement packing rings pre-cut to the correct width and length and packaged in sets be ordered from your Gorman-Rupp distributor or the factory. Lubricate the new packing rings with non-detergent oil before installation. For best performance, do not stretch or separate packing braids. Install the gasket first. Then install the first packing ring. Push each individual packing ring into the seal bore and compress it using a blunt-ended sleeve and mallet. Each successive layer must be compressed and rotated by 90 degrees to prevent excessive leakage. Be sure the lantern ring, if equipped, is aligned with the lubrication port when the packing is fully compressed. Add enough packing to fill the seat sleeve to within 3/8 of an inch of the end. Position the split gland halves on the shaft and install the gland retainers over the ends of the split gland. Install the hardware and tighten in an alternating pattern until the gland nuts begin to compress the packing. Do not over-tighten the gland nuts. If the packing rings are compressed too tightly, they may cause the shaft to overheat and damage the pump. If the idler pin was removed, apply pipe sealant to the OD of the replacement idler pin and the ID of the idler pin bore in the head. Position the pin in the head with the chamfered side toward the head and the milled flat side facing the crescent. Use a press to install the pin into the head. When properly installed, the pin will be positioned 1/100th of an inch below the surface of the crescent. Lightly oil the ID of the idler and use a press to install the idler bushing in the idler. The bushing should be centered at both ends of the idler. Place the head on a flat surface. Lightly oil the idler bushing. Install the idler assembly on the pin. Spin the idler to make certain that it moves freely on the pin. Install the head gasket and/or O-ring over the head. Carefully position the head and idler against the housing and engage the idler and rotor shaft assembly. Turn the rotor shaft until the idler and rotor teeth engage. Do not force. Slide the head into the housing assembly. Rotate the head until the groove in the head matches the groove in the housing. Secure the head to the housing with the cap screws. Clean the rotor adjusting sleeve and all component parts as previously described. Inspect the parts for wear or damage and replace as necessary. Use thumb pressure to install the bearing in the rotor adjusting sleeve until it bottoms out on the shoulder of the rotor adjusting sleeve. If equipped, install the bearing retaining cap and secure it to the rotor adjusting sleeve with the hardware. Tighten the cap screws until snug, then fully tighten in a cross sequence. Loosen the socket head set screws. Slide the rotor adjusting sleeve over the shaft. Screw the rotor adjusting sleeve into the back head until the rotor bottoms against the head. It is recommended that a new bearing lock washer be installed anytime the rotor adjusting sleeve is disassembled. Reuse of an old lock washer may create a preload condition on the bearing, resulting in premature bearing failure. Install a new bearing lock washer and screw the bearing lock nut onto the shaft until tight. Align one of the slots in the lock nut with one of the tabs on the lock washer and use a hammer and punch to bend the tab on the lock washer into the slot on the lock nut.
For more information on pump hydraulics, equipment, or application engineering, watch Gorman-Rupp's YouTube channel and visit us at grpumps.com.